ACAD is a framework of how to organize the classroom and the connections between the learning activities and task of designs. This framework was conceived to support both the analysis of activity within complex learning situations, as well as the forging of connections between this learning activity and the task of design. This framework considered that the learning activity must be dynamic and emergent, as well as physically, epistemically, and socially situated. This means that the design of the activity can influence this activity through the tasks that are proposed and through the shaping of the physical and social context in which the activity unfolds. One of the purposes this framework is pursuing is to try to connect the diversity of the things with its complex and how to connect the physical context with the activity we prepare. The relationship between place, tool and activities are a very important endeavor that teachers must do, but in many cases this is a very complex activity. To do this, teachers can use two processes to make it easier, affordance and interpretation, and also it can be taken into account two types of thinking, fast and slow thinking. There are at least two perspectives from which learning network can be analyzed. Egocentric perspective, which means that you see the whole network of learning from one of its members, and holistic perspective, which means that you look the whole network from above. There is another perspective that should also be taken into account, which is called the architectural perspective, which is based on activity perspective of the activity of design and the analysis of learning situations. There are three essential elements of this framework: set design, epistemic design, and social design. Set design refers to how we arrange to a final classroom. It means all the tools and devices we use, for example, the tables, the chairs, etc. Epistemic design, it's about proposing tasks and good things for students. This is the role of the teacher. First of all, let's explain what is a task. A task is a suggestion about something that is worth doing and that sometimes evolves subtask. Social designs. There are a lot of ways in which students can work together, through the division of labor, through roles, etc. And this can be used to explain the fact that this activity is socially situated. But to do this activity and ensure that it's profitable for all the participants, it must be also taken into account the people's capacity to do this. All these elements influence an important dimension of the framework called the emergent activities. Active learners have autonomy of what to do and how to do it. Activities where tools, tasks, and people come together in support of learning. To achieve the outcomes, teachers use activity as the mediator between tasks, people, and tools and outcomes. We refer to the different elements previously mentioned. All these dimensions influence are useful to remember how it can be done, the design, and how the results of the design can influence what students do.
So now I'm going to briefly talk to you guys about TPACK. So what TPACK basically is a framework or a model that is based on the idea of integrating pedagogical and curricular knowledge. This is something that all teachers must have in order to teach effectively and actually get through to their students. Its main focus is to integrate new elements such as technology and tools into the classroom or the learning process in an effective way, so that it means something to students and it means a positive impact in their learning outcomes. To understand TPACK, you need to know, you need to be clear that it's a mixture and a coming together of three different areas of knowledge, which are content, technology, and pedagogy. Now, to better understand content knowledge, you need to think of it as everything you need to know about a subject matter to transfer theoretical content and understanding to your students. And you need to come through as 100% certain and 100% confident. The only way to actually do this is to study everything you need to know about a subject. For example, if you have to teach biology, you need to know everything that a cell involves or the human body involves, so that you can summarize it and create a simple scheme to transpass to your students. Next, we move on to technology knowledge. This includes not only understanding of how technology works and how to use its tools, but also how it affects students' lives and how they relate to it and use it in their everyday lives. The reason why this is so important is because you need to know all the information you can use so as to design new methods and activities in a way that the students reach their full potential through technology, and their learning outcome is the best, basically. Lastly, we have pedagogical contents or pedagogical knowledge, which consists of the teacher knowing how to actually get through to their students in such a way that the assimilation of new concepts comes to them in the easiest way possible. This is achieved by teacher formation in subjects such as psychological education or educational psychology, as you will. And it consists of knowing how the student thinks and how the student develops and how this all applies to their learning. And the reason why this is so important is, again, because you need to design their activities and their methods, and they all need to be coherent with their stages of development and cognitive capacities. They all relate to each other in four different ways. First, we have pedagogical content knowledge, which is a mixture between content and pedagogy. So the reason why these have to mix is basically because content knowledge is not enough to be an actual effective teacher. This is the principal reason or factor why subject experts, such as, for example, a marine biology expert, cannot make a good teacher or an effective teacher. Because no matter how much they know about a subject, they don't have the knowledge necessary about pedagogy to actually make students understand and assimilate new concepts about biology. So a teacher which might not know as much about marine biology as an expert might be more effective in making students learn because they know how students think and how they assimilate new concepts. Next, we go on to technological content knowledge, which is finding tools and ways to integrate theoretical concepts into learning processes using technology. So then you need to go on to technological pedagogical knowledge. This is the use of technological tools in the design of learning activities and new methods to facilitate engagement, which makes them pay more attention and retain more information. The reason why engaging students with technology is so important is because it increases their motivation towards learning and it results in better academic results and success. These four things altogether make TPACK, which, as you know it, is the mixture of all knowledge you need to have to be an effective teacher. So, the way in which these two concepts, ACAD and TPACK, are related is that they both are focused on teaching in such a way that it benefits students' learning. But a very important factor or difference that you need to know about these is that ACAD is actually focused on activity design and TPACK is more focused on the essential knowledge a teacher must have to teach effectively. And that is it.